This is Coding Math Mini number 5, the Pythagorean Theorem and Distance. I've mentioned this concept a few times in other videos, and it's been used a couple of times in the code libraries we've been creating. It's time to give it a few minutes of its own. The Pythagorean Theorem says that the square of the hypotenuse of a right triangle is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides of that triangle. Now, what does this even mean? Well, if we take a right triangle, and we label this side A, this one B, in the hypotenuse C, then we take the length of side A, square it, add it to the length of side B squared, and that will equal the length of C squared. And you get the old line you're probably familiar with from high school, A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Simple enough, but what does that even mean, and why do we care? Now usually you see it visualized like this, with squares drawn on each side. So the area of this square plus the area of this square will equal the area of that square. It's a nice visual proof, but it's not particularly useful, unless you're trying to figure out the areas of squares that happen to be laid out like this for some mysterious reason. In most cases where the Pythagorean theorem is useful, the fact of these squares themselves is irrelevant. They're merely a means to an end. The goal is usually to find out the length of one side of the triangle when you know the other two. Now, you can do this all with trigonometry. Say you know the length of A and B. You can use arctangent to get this angle here. Then, to get the hypotenuse C, divide this opposite side B by the sine of this angle, or divide the adjacent sine by the cosine of that angle. But either way, you're using two trig functions, which can be costly in terms of computer time. So you square side A, square side B, add them together, and take the square root of that value, and there's your hypotenuse. Now, square root is usually costly too, but at least you're only doing it once. So what is this used for? The most common use is finding the distance between two points. Say you have two points, any points located anywhere. You can then lay a coordinate system down and see that each one has an x and a y position. Now, you can draw a line from one point to the other that will represent the distance between them. Then draw a line on the x-axis that goes from the x position of one to the x position of the other, and another line on the y-axis that goes from the y position of one point to the y position of the other. And what do you know? You have a right triangle. The distance between the two points is the hypotenuse of the triangle. This leg here on the x-axis is the difference between the x positions of the two points. You literally just subtract the two x's. I usually call this dx. And the leg on the y-axis is just the difference between the two y-positions. Again, just subtract them. We'll call this dy. Let's say this point is 2, 1, and this point is 6, 4. Subtracting the x's gives you 6 minus 2, so the length of this side is 4. Subtracting the y's gives you 4 minus 1, or 3 for the length of this side. You square those and you get 16 and 9. Add those together, you get 25, which is the square of the hypotenuse. Take the square root of that, and you get 5. So these two points are 5 units apart. Now, you might be wondering why I chose one point to subtract from the other. It happens that I chose the point with the largest coordinates to go first, and subtracted the other point from that. But in fact, it doesn't matter. Had I done it the other way around, I would have gotten sides of minus 4, and minus 3, but once you square those, you're back to 16 and 9, and it all goes the same after that. So you can make a distance function that takes two points like so. You subtract the x's and the y's, you square them, add them together, and return the square root of that. This assumes that you have some kind of objects that have x and y properties. Again, it doesn't matter if you subtract p0 from p1 or vice versa. Once you square them, it all comes out the same. You can make another version that uses raw xy values like so. Other than the fact that it gets four simple number parameters instead of two objects, it's doing the exact same thing. To demonstrate this in action, I've set up a simple file that you can see here. It's the usual canvas template. I define center x and center y variables that point to the center of the canvas, and then the distance xy function we just created. Then I listen for the mouse move event. Inside the mouse move handler, I clear the canvas and then check the distance from the current mouse position to that center point. If it's less than 100 pixels, I set the fill style of the canvas to a red color, otherwise it's set to gray. Then I just draw a 100 pixel radius circle at that center point. Running that on the browser, we have a gray circle, but when you move the mouse over the circle, it turns red. Move it back out, back to gray. So there you go. There are obviously tons of uses for this, and I'm sure we'll run into this in many future episodes. See you around.